All right, everybody, welcome to MLM Monday. My name is Ben Dixon, your host, and I'm super excited to connect with you today. If you're just joining us, brand new, today is episode 124. Fantastic. And we're going to be jumping into some great topics here in just a moment. If you haven't yet been on the show before, you're new for the first time, go ahead and comment below where you're watching from. If you're watching on replay, and go ahead and say replay and comment in. Watch where you're from if you want to hear about a topic on direct sales, network marketing, multi-level marketing. Hop on in the comments and we will connect with you to feature those pieces. For those of you that haven't met, my name is Ben Dixon. I'm blessed to be the CEO at NaXum Online Marketing Systems and get the opportunity to serve in the forum with the Direct Selling Executives Forum as well. And all right, we got some folks connecting live. Good to have you here. And today's topic is going to be a follow-up to what we've been covering. The last few weeks, we've been talking about trends for 2020 to engage in. There's six trends we wrote about in the direct selling trends, the 2020 direct selling trends report that's available on our site. If you haven't yet gotten a copy or need help grabbing a copy, PM me on Facebook. We'll get you connected to the team, get you a copy of the report. It's free and you want to read it. The trend we're talking about today is trend number two on the report, and that is gig economy influence. So it's hard to argue if you're in direct sales or network marketing that the gig economy has not affected you in any way. It is true that the Ubers and DoorDashes and Lyfts of our world have solved that $100 to $400 a month problem for tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of families all around the world. So where network marketing and direct sales used to be the vehicle to solve the $100 to $400 a month cash flow problem in a family's life, now we compete with the gig economy. And so what are some of the things we can learn from the gig economy inside of direct sales that we can apply in an important way? Now, there's a couple key distinctions to walk through as you jump into this topic, key things that that make it powerful for us to look at this and things we can learn from. One of the first ones that I like is what I call the you can do it factor, okay? When someone looks at the opportunity to go pick up and drop off people with their car with Uber, right, are they confident that they have the ability to execute on what's needed to make some money? Yes, right? They have driver's license, they have a car, they pick up and drop off their kids anyway, might as well pick up and drop off other people for that extra money in their life. That's the you can do it factor. So it's that easy to do that when they look at the opportunity to make some other income in their life, they know they can do it. So you got to think about how you can increase that you can do it factor. Now, something else that a lot of people point out when you start talking about the gig economy versus direct sales and network marketing is the idea of who gets the customer, right? When you go on Uber, you don't have to tell your friends you're doing Uber and if they want a ride to call you. No, Uber gets you the customer. If you're on DoorDash, you don't have to ask your friends, hey, do you guys want any food delivered to your house? Nope, they get you the customer. So you start to understand, oh, they're getting the customer for people. Yes, they are. Now, in direct sales, are we getting the customer for people? Well, some companies are, right? Some companies in the space are doing influencer marketing and co-op rotators and generating customers and giving them the qualified people of a certain rank in the company. Most aren't. So what are we doing because of the gig economy inside of direct sales to help people get the customer? That's where a lot of the pre-written marketing content and predictive text comes into play in the space today. We are seeing it make a big difference. You see, for those of you that are running a direct sales company or those of you that are building teams, you all know that it's not about what a leader can do. It's about what the newest person with the least amount of knowledge, can that person duplicate into somebody who's creating sales and earning inside of an organization and a company? So to answer that question, we got to roll back a little bit and say, okay, what does that person need to be successful? Well, they need the you can do it factor in the gig economy, and they need to be able to generate customers. So what does that look like? What are some of the, just if we throw them out there, what are some of the things people are doing today to have the you can do it factor and help them generate the customer? Pre-written content, okay? Corporate direct sales companies all over the space are providing done-for-you content for the members to tap and share. Whether they're tap and sharing from an app, copy and pasting from a virtual office, they are providing the content to share marketing systems. If you're trying to build a direct sales company today and you just have a replicated site and a commission engine and you hope you're going to be successful and that's going to be enough, you're wrong. You need a full marketing platform so that when new people look at a company, they say, wow, I can do that. You want to put together systems and content and tools so that they have a path to generating new retail customers through your systems in the platform. That's what it all comes down to. If those systems aren't in place and someone wants to lead and win and dominate in your company, they as a leader have to create them for their own team. And that's crazy. Do they need to be creating systems for their own team or actually out there just building and actually doing the work, the relationships? You're right. So as if you're running a direct sales company today, you have to look at the types of systems you're creating. Now, if you haven't yet delved into predictive action technology, this is some of the newest stuff we see companies implementing in the space, and it is influenced heavily from the gig economy, and that's doing the work to even move away from a reporting-based culture of look at reports to know what to do to an action-based culture, actually taking the work of interviewing your top leaders and saying, hey, what do you say in these scenarios? Like, if so-and-so hasn't placed an order in the last 35 days, what would you tell them? If so-and-so went to the business webinar and they registered and they watched it, but they didn't join, what would you say to that person? Hey, if you invited so-and-so to go to a three-way call with your mentor, but they ignored you, what would you say to that person? You literally go through hundreds of scenarios and codify what you'd want someone to say. And just like Gmail finishes your sentences when you start typing emails today and LinkedIn tells you who to wish happy anniversary, that's right, direct sales companies today are setting up apps and platforms where it literally is telling the member what to do, not go look at the report to know what to do, but literally telling them what to do and then pre-populating that messaging for them in the space. That's the type of stuff we see today in gig economy influence. And that's the level you play at today so that you can have the you can do it factor. If you'd like to see a demo on that type of technology, how people actually implement that in the space, feel free to message me here on Facebook, or you can comment below on the video feed itself, or you can email at ben@naxum.com. I have a video link that we can send out to you from a study that we did, and you can get a chance to see what it looks like to put predictive action technology to work. So what are you going to do about the gig economy? Those of you who are watching, how are you going to update yourself? What are you going to do to make your business relevant in the space? Comment below. We'll talk with you soon. Bye for now.